Snake Eyes, I'm just waiting for the other half to sew them back on.
You want I should talk to a smart guy?
Way you handle things, Vic, I'll take my chances with the man upstairs.
You better hope he's smiling at you, Al.
Way he's looking down on you, Jimmy Clean Hands?
He knows a good man when he sees one.
He can also spot an asshole a mile away.
It's like he's got your number, Jimmy.
I'm praying for all of you.
Well, while you're kissing God's ass, you can spare a few minutes for mine.
Don Franco.
Don Franco.
Don Franco.
Take a seat, gentlemen. Now, I've called you all here for an important reason.
Times are tough. We've had to make a lot of cutbacks. First, our operations got scaled back. And now, I gotta make an ask of you guys. We can't afford to have guns anymore.
Yeah, you gotta be kidding me. Can't be
so. No, I gotta take back your guns and have them melted down.
You can't melt down the 38. The love has been in the family since Grandfather came over here.
I'm sorry, Jimmy, but we need the money. Believe me, the family is dead without it. Joey, collect the guns.
So how do you expect us to do business without him?
Look, I got it covered, smart guy. I'm not letting you boys go around naked. You're gonna have protection, just not with a trigger.
What about in the safe, Joey?
So what are we gonna have?
Mr. Town?
Thank you, Don Franco. Well, gentlemen, things are looking bleak. At least that's one way to look at it.
Who the hell is this guy?
Robert Town, Mr. Finucci. Now, I was told by Don Franco that you boys have a problem, and I intend to fix it. Now, first off, let's establish how much of an inconvenience not having a gun really is.
Pen, Albert.
Now, sure, a gun is handy in your line of work.
It's threatening, and you can shoot a hole in a man's face with it.
But it's also cumbersome, heavy, and if the authorities catch you with one, you could end up being someone's girlfriend in a state correctional facility. And I don't think any of us want to cough, Albert.
Don Franco.
Just go with the flow, smart guy.
Thank you, Don Franco. Let's just put aside the gun for a second, shall we? And see what else we have at our disposal.
Harsh language.
That's a great start, Mr. Finucci.
The rock boy?
You didn't tell them? Oh, I'm just kidding. Of course you get to keep your wire. Oh, my stars. So that's harsh language, garrote wire, hand-to-hand combat, and blunt objects. Not a very impressive list, is it?
No shit.
Okay, well, let me throw in a new factor. What throughout the history of man has been the one constant factor that has caused more pain, fear, and death than any other weapon on the face of the planet?
Love?
In the mid-90s, a criminal once robbed a bank using only a mobile phone. On the other end of the line was a young woman who claimed she was the man's hostage and that if the bank employees didn't hand over $50,000 in cash, she would be killed. Not one to be seen allowing the death of a young girl, the criminal got away with it. And all because he was able to convince the bank of a perceived threat. So it would seem to me, gentlemen, that the threat of violence is more palpable than the expression of violence. And on that note, I give you the banana. Albert! Sure, it's not the most threatening of fruits. But if I were to alter your perception of it, say, I'm gonna shoot your ass to hell, you goddamn son of a bitch!
It's a banana.
No disrespect, Don Franco, but what if somebody catches us off guard with this tank?
Joey, you scared the piss out of us. Where you been? Joey? Don Panino, you son of a bitch! What the hell are you doing with my daughter?
Just take it easy, Franco. And the girl walks away without a scratch.
Are you alright, Connie?
I'm fine, Papa. These apes jumped me at the skate rink and I couldn't shake them.
Careful, sweet lips. When I say fun, you fall down and play dead.
What?
What do you want, Panino?
Your operations, in exchange for the girl's life.
Don't worry about me, Papa.
Shut up!
Guess you ain't familiar with the power of the banana, Don Panino.
What are you doing, Pink Pantry? You're gonna get us all killed! I mean, great initiative.
Did you know that the seeds of a banana move faster than the speed of sound? I'd only have to aim this thing at my friend here, and he'd be dead before I could finish talking. Sorry, Romeo. It's been fun.
In places.
Johnny!
What is this nonsense? Get up, you fool.
Go check his pulse, Louis. It's just fruit, you idiot.
Maybe, but if that was the case, could I take out smart guy? Nick and the Don.
Daddy, get up!
Are you sure you want to shoot a Panino? Now turn around and face the wall. The rest of you lazy bastards can get up now.
Papa, you asshole. I thought you were dead.
I knew it.
So, Jimmy Pantangeli gets his hands dirty.
It's only fruit, smart guy.
Well, I must say that I'm impressed with all of you. You took my initial concept, then you ran with it. Fabulous. Well, you obviously no longer require my assistance. So me and my assistant will be leaving you to it. It's been fun.
Vic?
Yeah?
Make sure Mr. Tom fits into his briefcase.
I think you mean leaves with his briefcase.
Well, you see, Mr. Town, it's all about perception.
Oh, Mother!